Jalisco's second largest city, the capital of the state of Jalisco, a sprawling city home to over 5 million people, the center for Jalisco's art, music, and of course, food. I'm getting my first taste of this thriving city, starting with its most famous creation, the torta ahogada.
Every bite, it keeps on changing.
Then, I'm meeting up with one of the best chefs in the city to see how his gorgeous recipes are changing the way we think about market food. In my kitchen, that torta ahogada inspires another tasty torta. I'm making bolillos from scratch, a chunky avocado and cucumber salad, and an adobo marinated slow-cooked pork tatemado de puerco to pack an irresistible torta.
With one, you're done.
I don't know.
No, you would have another one? Lame, lame, lame tu chocolate, lame, lame, lame café caliente, lame, lame,
lame tu corazón. Patty's Mexican Table is made possible by
La Costeña, por sabor.
Avocados from Mexico.
Food brand cheese with traditional Mexican flavor.
Stand Together, helping every person rise. More information at standtogether.org.
Mahatma Rice lets you unite ingredients and flavors. Mahatma Rice unites.
King Arthur Baking Company. Find out more about Unmasa Harina at kingarthurbaking.com.
Oleico, high oleic safflower oil.
Tecate. Mexico is in us.
FEMSA Foundation.
There are certain foods that you automatically connect to a city, like New York and pizza, or Paris and croissants. For Guadalajara, no question. It's the torta ahogada. Sure, it starts off looking like a regular delicious Mexican sandwich, but then it's baked again, and again, and again, with three mouth-watering salsas. You can find tortas ahogadas in the many food stands dotted everywhere in Guadalajara. But this is one of the most popular in the city, and I can't wait to try it. ¿Usted es el profe Jiménez?
No, soy su hijo. Pues ya somos yo y mi hermano.
¿Usted es su hermano?
Sí, exactamente.
¿Cómo se llaman y cómo se llaman?
Él es Alex y yo soy Paco.
They're the sons of the Profe Jiménez, who started this stand.
Hace 41 años.
41 años.
Vamos a cumplir 41 años.
This place has been here for so long, and it's so famous, people come from everywhere to try the tortas ahogadas. Veniste de McAllen?
Yes.
This is your first day here?
First day, yeah.
The tortas they make here are legendary. Like any great sandwich, it all starts with the bread. A ver, ¿tienes el pan?
Es el pan salado.
A ver, okay. Este es el... Oh, it is really hard. So, tortas ahogadas are made with birote. Y este pan es solo de aquí,
solo
¿no?
Solo de Guadalajara, sí.
The salty French-inspired rolls, called birotes, are handmade by the thousands in local bakeries, just like this one. They really say that birote you can only make here. You can't replicate it. Some people say it's the weather, some people say it's the water, some people say it's the people, pero it is, you can see how it is. No se dice drunken. Drunken is drunk. It's a, ¿cómo se dice ahogado en inglés?
Drowned.
Mmm. I was saying drunken torta, but it is really drowned torta, but it is really a very famous torta for people that have gotten drunk. So I guess it's the same thing, or they go together.
The meat for tortas ahogadas are carnitas, of course.
Es la torta clásica.
First, the birote gets a swipe of mayo. Then it's stuffed with yummy carnitas and topped with cilantro and onion. Then the drowning begins, starting with a chile de árbol salsa, followed by a cold tomato sauce. Then it all gets drenched in the same, but this time heated, tomato sauce.
Uy! The combination of sauces, it
makes the spicy one, then the cold tomato one that tastes fresh, and then the hot tomato one, which is like making the bread a little bit soggy, but because it's so resilient, you can bite and chew into it. You don't find this in McAllen.
Not even the bread.
Did you try it already?
No, when my wife is eating the torta ahogada thing, I'm eating the...
Destruido.
Destruido.
¿Qué es el destruido?
Es un taco dorado.
¿Relleno de qué?
Papa o frijol.
Oh, this is a new thing to me. This is called the destroyed. And it's a crispy taco.
Sí, claro. Uh-huh.
Uy, you know, that always fascinates me about Mexico. Like, there's the classics. You come from the classics, and then you get to know that there's a new thing that becomes a new classic.
Ya con un poco de chicharrón.
Uy, totally my kind of food. This is so right up my alley. I'm already in love with this thing. Come for the torta ahogada, stay for the destruido, and then come back again for the torta ahogada. Gracias a los dos. Muchas gracias. I think one of the most famous tortas, not only of Jalisco or the city of Guadalajara, but of the entire country of Mexico, is the torta ahogada. But there's another category of tortas that in Jalisco goes by the name of lonche. We're gonna stuff this lonche with a tatemado de puerco. Lonche really comes from the American word lunch. To make a lonche really irresistible, you have to have the main filling be like to die for. You build it and sauce it and really garnish it from the inside. You're gonna see it's really irresistible. I have here 1 pound of pork butt that I cut into 1-inch chunks. And I also have 1 pound of pork ribs that I cut into smaller pieces. I'm gonna add 1 tablespoon of salt, 1/3 cup of apple cider vinegar, is going to start breaking down the meat so that it will come really tender. And it also helps like balance the flavors. Let this meat sit anywhere from 1 hour to 24 hours. Now we're gonna make the adobo. I'm gonna use 4 guajillo chiles, which I'm going to stem. This adobo is gonna have it all because it's gonna have the chiles, it's gonna have chocolate, vinegar, and I really think this one is a keeper. We're gonna toast these guajillo chiles. We just want them to change color, change texture. We're gonna start to get some of the fumes of the chiles and the aroma, and that means we're unlocking the flavor of the dried chiles. Now I'm gonna use 2 chiles de árbol. This is a chile de árbol from Yahualica. Yahualica is a region in the state of Jalisco that grows this chile. The people of Jalisco are really proud about their chile de árbol, because it's really unique. It has a lot of heat, but what happens with this chile de árbol is that the heat, you feel it and it goes by fast, and then you taste the flavor. It doesn't matter if they char too much, because we want that charred flavor. And talking about charred, that's where the word tatemado comes from. That means to put an ingredient close to the fire until it will almost get burnt. But it doesn't get burnt. We want the toasted ingredients in the boiling water to rehydrate, and I'm going to add 2 cloves of garlic and fresh ginger. Oh, I love the smell of ginger. You can see how the chiles are starting to go from very dry and almost brittle to kind of plump and meaty. Now, toasting the dried spices does the same thing as toasting the chile. So if you have the extra minute, go ahead. Once I add the oregano and the thyme and the cumin seeds, the moment they hit the hot surface, I can smell the spices. Like their essence is getting unlocked with the heat. I'm adding 4 whole cloves, but I'm removing the stem, and sesame seeds. We're also toasting 1 inch of canela. We're stirring these because we don't want the spices to burn. The chiles are ready and rehydrated. Also, the garlic and fresh ginger that cooked. I'm adding about a cup of the cooking liquid. The last thing I'm adding is Mexican chocolate. And this was also surprising to me. Think about caramelized ginger and how that would go with something spicy and something chocolatey. That's what this is. It's really good. You want to find Mexican chocolate. It has a lot of granulated sugar. I'm going to show you. You can see how grainy it is. You can see the sugar. You can see the cinnamon. I'm going to add 2 ounces of the chocolate. I mean, the chili and the ginger are loving this right now. We're just gonna puree this until completely smooth. You really wanna take the time to puree this because you have that piece of cinnamon, you have that chocolate. You wanna make sure it's really smooth. Oh, the color is just gorgeous. Okay, so we have the adobo, and as soon as it cools, I'm gonna pour it onto the meat and rub it all over and then let it sit in this adobo for a while. Look at the color of the adobo. I mean, this is stunning. I'm gonna put this in the refrigerator, and really this, the more that it sits, the better it gets. So you can marinate it anywhere from an hour to 24 hours. It's been a while. Our meat is going to be in the oven cooking until it's completely cooked and tender. And the adobo has changed from being this deeply flavorful to insanely flavorful because it will have cooked with all of the juices from the meat. Okay, 375 for 2 hours. So many people think about tortillas when they think about Mexican food, but we love our bread too. And one of Mexico's go-to breads is called the bolillo. Now, the bolillo is the adaptation of the French baguette. I'm gonna start by leveling 3 cups of flour. It's gonna be 3 1/4. You have to be precise when you're baking. And then we have 3 leveled teaspoons of instant yeast, 2 1/2 teaspoons of sugar, 2 teaspoons salt. So the bolillos have that sweet, salty taste, but it's very balanced and soft. And then I'm gonna add 1 1/4 cups. You wanna make sure that the water is lukewarm. We're gonna beat these until it's soft and elastic, so like 3 to 4 minutes. See how soft, and it's a little bit sticky, which you want. I'm going to cover it, and I'm gonna let it double in size. It's gonna take anywhere from 1 to 1 1/2 hours, and you wanna put it in a warm area of your kitchen where it will puff up. We've already met the famous torta ahogada. But Guadalajara's culinary scene goes way beyond that. Chef Fabián Delgado is expanding local culinary horizons at his contemporary market counter, Unites. Hola, Fabián.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
¿Cómo estás? ¿Cómo estás? ¿Vuelvo atrás?
Así, mira.
Sí.
¿Cómo va todo?
¡Qué rico visitarte! ¡Qué bonito lugar!
Unites is located within Guadalajara's Mercado 4. Throughout my travels in Mexico, I've eaten at many market stands that serve delicious, typical local dishes. But never ever have I been to a market restaurant like Unites.
¿Me puedo invitar de celado?
Sí, claro.
Sí. I just invited myself in the kitchen. Porque te quiero ver cocinar. Mira qué belleza.
Estamos haciendo platos rancheros.
Ajá.
Por eso es el tema de los menjurjes, ¿no? Como
ajá.
Mi familia, por ejemplo, es de Tequila, Jalisco.
Ajá.
Y es un pueblo al que le tengo mucho, mucho cariño.
¿Tu familia es de Tequila?
Sí, mi familia es de Tequila.
Ajá. Cuando dices que algo está ranchero, no es necesariamente a ranch, ¿no?
No, para nada.
¿Te refieres a rancho?
La gente ranchera consume sus productos.
Sí.
Que hacen los lácteos. Que es de sus propias vacas.
No procesado, a más natural,
completamente.
A más real.
What sets Fabian apart is how he uses modern culinary concepts while staying firmly connected to his roots. And the people who supply the raw materials for his innovative dishes.
Sales, les compramos a Doña Vicky, que está allá. Salude, Doña Vicky, por favor.
Doña Vicky.
Mire, y mira, compa, dame 5 pitayas.
¡Pitayas!
La
y
cosa
son pitayas frescas.
Sí, sí, sí.
¡Qué belleza! ¡Mira la pitaya! Ya, lista para darle la mordida. It's clear that Fabian takes great pride in the ingredients that he uses.
Es una cosa de calidad increíble, los lácteos que usamos.
Lucky for me, he can't wait to share them.
Esto tienes que probarlo.
Sí.
Esto es mantequilla agria.
Uy.
Mira, le voy a poner un poquito de sal. Ajá. Le voy a poner cenizas de tortilla.
Uy.
La cocina de Jalisco tiene mucho de cenizas. Es deliciosa. Mm. Parece un ricota. Y esto es la fermentación de la leche. Esto se llama jocoque.
No, ya.
Es una cosa increíble.
Mm.
Este taquito.
Ajá. Con.
Queso asadero.
Ajá.
Hongos y flor de calabaza.
Uy.
¿Va? Y la salsa es de jocoque, crema y queso cotija. Un poco de salsa macha. Lo único que tenemos que hacer aquí es probarla.
This is good, like really good.
Oro puro. Te voy a hacer un taquito, el mole, ¿vale?
¿Esa qué es, carnita?
Esta es lomo de cerdo. A mí me gusta mucho doradita.
A mí también.
Ah, bueno. Este es un mole muy, muy, muy sencillo. Lo puede hacer cualquier gente en la casa.
Muchos chiles, pocos chiles.
Son 10 ingredientes. That's it.
Se llama mole dulce.
Se llama mole dulce.
Para ti, tú estás enamorado de la gastronomía de Jalisco.
Yo estoy enamorado de lo que se puede hacer con el conocimiento que tenemos de la cocina de Jalisco. Es delicioso.
He wants to share his sweets.
Este okay. Se llama espejo, que es con un glaseado, es una galleta muy básica de vainilla. O sea, la nutrición no es este momento.
Si le pudieras decir algo a la gente que nunca ha venido a Jalisco, de la cocina de aquí.
No solamente es la torta ahogada, no es la birria y no es la carne en su jugo. Hay muchísima cocina vegetal, hay muchísimas frutas. Hablando de...
Sí.
Tienes las pitayas, ¿no?
Sí.
Que las pitayas las tienes un mes.
We're just gonna continue eating and talking and tasting and eating and talking.
Mira.
You have to come to Jalisco if you want some of it.
Y para que sigas con la boca llena, tienes que probar esto. Esto es algo muy clásico. Es la empanada.
I like this. And you will like it when you make this too. It puffed up. I just enjoy the plop. But I'm gonna dust with a little bit of flour. I'm gonna cut this into 8 pieces. We're gonna turn these pieces into small balls. But there's a technique to do this, okay? I'm gonna push a little bit down and then turn all the edges inwards, which is just really satisfying. You're pinching the dough into a ball. And it feels like a little balloon. When you let the balls of dough rest, the gluten relaxes, so it's easier to shape. They keep getting a little bit more puffed up as time goes by. You wanna cover these balls with water. You can either use a spray, like I'm doing right now, or you can also brush it. We don't want these balls to dry out. And now we're gonna cover them and we're gonna let them sit for just 10 minutes. They got even puffier. And now what we're gonna do is we're going to reshape them into the true bolillo form. You stretch it out a little. I'm looking at like 4 to 5 inches.
take the bottom corner and you're gonna make like a folded envelope. Go to the center. And you do that as many times as you can. And then you just go like that with your hands so that you get the signature bolillo shape, very chubby in the middle. The bolillo is really used for everything. It's a bread that's used for tortas and sandwiches, but it's also a bread that's just table bread. We're gonna spray these with water one more time. We're gonna cover them again, and we're gonna let them rest for an hour. So this has been cooking for a couple of hours, and it looks beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. The pork has already cooked and it's nice and soft. I'm gonna put it in the oven for another like 30 to 45 minutes because this is what it's going to make it tatemado. We're gonna use ripe avocado to make a chunky avocado and cucumber salad in a crema dressing. So I'm gonna start with the dressing. I'm gonna use 5 tablespoons of this Mexican style sour cream. 2 tablespoons of yogurt because I wanna mix the crema with a different kind of acidic. I want a dressing that is gonna make me go like this when I have the salad. The zest of a lime, and then we're gonna get the juice of the lime. I'm going to add some salt, a generous teaspoon. I'm gonna chop a jalapeño with the seeds and all, because I want all of the flavor in here. 1 clove of garlic, a little cilantro, and I'm gonna do the cucumber. Some scallions, then we're gonna add the avocado. One of the benefits of having a creamy yogurt or crema dressing for anything that has avocado is that it will help preserve it and look beautiful while it waits for you. Yum. We're gonna add a lot of cotija cheese because salty, aged, delicious. Just look at this. So the meat was already succulent and falling apart and so tender. And this is the tatemado finish. Crunchy, crusty, charred, rustic. Oh, oh my God. Look at how pretty these are. Adorable and chubby. I mean, look at how puffy they are. We're doing the spray now because the dough is so pillowy and puffy that it's very hard to make a slit. I'm gonna make a slit from end to end. You have to be fast. Takes a little practice. Some bread makers in Mexico will make the line to the side, so it's like your signature. Some bread makers do it to the middle. I have my oven at 400 degrees, and these are gonna bake for 18 to 20 minutes until they're brown on the top and fully cooked.
Hola.
Mi amor, te estoy haciendo esta torta otra vez.
No, like, that looks insane.
I mean, look at these.
How long did it take to cook?
So 2 hours covered,
yeah,
and then 1 hour uncovered.
Mm-hmm.
Let's each one build our own torta.
Okay.
Let's start by spreading refried beans. I'm packing it up, okay?
Okay.
I will take the cream that you are not taking.
Yeah.
Panela cheese. ¿Eso de jalapeños? I mean, I think we could finish this in 3 tortas.
Easily.
No? And then we're adding the salad. And everything has crema.
Yeah. This is big.
Oh, this is huge.
All right, should we eat it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's so good.
It's like messy, salty, tangy.
It's the perfect amount of spicy, too.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
This is one of my favorite things you've ever made.
You know what? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Oh, did you try the salad? Tiene el cotija cheese.
Yeah, it's fresh.
It feels light next to the torta, but I feel like this is a salad that can also stand on its own.
Yeah. Is that cilantro or what is
mm-hmm.
that?
Yeah, and scallions.
It's really fresh, yeah. If you opened up a stand for just these tortas, I'd do pretty well.
Will you partner with me?
Mm-hmm.
For recipes and information from this episode and more, visit patijinich.com. And connect! Find me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Pinterest at Pati Jinich.
Patty's Mexican Table is made possible by...
La Costeña, por sabor.
Avocados from Mexico.
Food brand meats with traditional Mexican flavor.
Stand Together, helping every person rise. More information at standtogether.org.
Mahatma Rice lets you unite ingredients and flavors. Mahatma Rice unites.
King Arthur Baking Company. Find out more about masa harina at kingarthurbaking.com.
Oleico, high oleic safflower oil.
Tecate. Mexico is in us.
FEMSA Foundation.
Proud to support Patty's Mexican Table on public television.